Watcher, so here we are, back in the reeds. So it's Wednesday night. I was down Monday night and blanked. I didn't put any bait on the Sunday night, but I did bait up with a kilo on Saturday night. And of course I baited up every night last week as well with half a kilo. And I had that linear out on a Friday. So on the Monday I blanked, even though there was a carp rolled out over there and here. And was feeding. I didn't manage to catch anything. Could have been a fish that I'd already caught, which of course means it's going to be difficult to catch again. Not that I want to catch it again. I'd like to catch something different. So I reckon there's about 7 to 9, possibly 9, but I think 7. It's difficult to say. We've just had a fish roll out there, and I'm pretty sure it's a carp, and there's the bubbles coming up from the carp. But that is definitely a carp. So there's a carp in the swim. That doesn't surprise me, because Monday night I put a kilo in, came down Tuesday evening, they'd all gone, that I could see in front of me on the shelf, that had all gone, and it's out of reach of the swans and the ducks, pretty much. Well, the ducks, I haven't seen them feeding on my bait. But no, I'm pretty sure the carp have taken it all, and I don't think it's bream. I am fishing on a shelf and then down into the gully, the deeper trench, as it were, of the river, but down at the bottom, which is 6 foot, just about a rod length and a half out, which is where that carp was actually feeding, bubbling and mould. So the bait's going on the top, down the slope, and then down on the drop-off. That's where it's going. I've got two rods poking out this way, as you can see, because I've abandoned that spot. This left-hand rod's just going to go down to the left here, just here, where it's a clear spot, which has been created by the bait I've been putting in. And the right-hand rod's going to go out there, just down at the bottom of the gully. And like I say, this left-hand rod's going to be up on top, just to the left. Okay, let's get the bags out, because they're both bagged up, ready to go. We can get a handful of bait on each one. I'll set the camera up just next to me here for the first hour. If I don't catch anything, then I'll just do standard blog entries. And the reason for that is that it runs the batteries down. I've got a limited amount of film left. It takes forever to go through all the hours and hours of film. So, yeah. Nice bit of debris floating down there. Wouldn't want to get that on the line. One of the hazards of river fishing. Okay, we're all set, traps are laid, just make sure that this camera's not too ski whiff. There you go. Here comes the pleasure boat cruiser, Georgina. And that's all the debris from the wash of the boat moving. All the debris in the margins, taking the lines. So now the debris's got a reset, and of course it's gone straight over my swim. So I'm going to leave it until it settles. I don't know if you can see what the boat has done. It's put all that crap all over the swim, and it's all around the lines. And there's nothing I can do about it. So I'm just going to have to sit here and suffer the consequences for a while. Let the flow of the river move that stuff and settle it all on. Well, that's really messed me fishing up, that has. So I'm a bit concerned about all this debris. Wind. I'm thinking of taking the rods out, clearing the debris away and starting again. Okay, this debris not going to go anywhere. It's all over the front of the swim. I need to get rid of it. I need to get my rigs out. So. That's how bad it is. Well, the water's gone a bit cloudy, and whether it's from that large boat or
or what, I don't know. It's definitely gold. Quite coloured.
I'm going to put half a dozen baits around each rod as well. It won't hurt. I'm going to make sure there are some baits around each rod. Okay, so we're all set up again. Hopefully we won't get too many boats like that coming along here. It just depends on how much of the debris is collected. There's loads and loads of dead weed floating down here. Well, not dead weed, chopped weed. We have weed cutters on the cam. It's just loads and loads of it. It forms huge mats. Get it all in the margins along here, it can be a pain in the arse. Just have to struggle on with it, don't you? See, that only took about 5 or 10 minutes to sort out. Much better than sitting there for any length of time with all that mess. I think if I had got a take, it would have been touch and go with all that weed all over the top of the line like that. So I'm glad I did that. So the high rod position is keeping the line out of the way of the reeds and all the weed debris that's just underneath the rods and in the margin here. There's quite a bit floating down, but I've got a lot just to my left here acting as a block, so it's kind of keeping this area clear for me, partially. Keep adjusting it tonight. Certainly don't want to get a run when that's floating by. It's half a tree in there, I think. Yeah, right over my right hand rod.
That's going to get the weed moving.
There's an awful lot of debris coming down at the moment, so it's going to cause a problem if I get a carp on, obviously. Still, there's plenty of weed out there anyway.
That's the other one. That's really good. 157.
Well, we're nicely out of the wind here at least, because it is well windy out there, as you can see. Very gusty. Well, it's 7:15, so it's the busy period. Going to be a lot of boats coming on now, I suppose. But I'm going to give it at least another hour or so. But yeah. We could be miles from any fish, this is true. I haven't kept in touch with them lately. I've just not been able to get down here, and the weather's not been conducive for it either, for spotting them. Anyway, something's eaten the bait, so hopefully we'll catch the culprit.
You let the boat run underneath you. You will go same speed as the water. Boat will run on ahead.
So this is hardcore carping, isn't it? All these boats, I mean, you know, you just have to put up with it. I've had fish while they've been coming along here like this, so, you know, this is the time of day I've been catching them, so. Yeah. But it is a bit quiet, isn't it? Like I say, the boat's still going, and I want to catch the culprit. time. With the boats still going by, hold on, let me just do the camera. So, caught myself one of the smaller fish out of the can. One of the fish of the future, of course. It's a very lively little common. I'd say it's just about on double figures. Hold on. Took the right hand rod. Look at that. That is in perfect condition. Hold on. There you go. Look at that. Absolutely perfect condition. Has it got a... Yep, there's a curtain in its mouth, so it hasn't been caught too many times, I should think. Mostly the curtain gets torn away by the line after 3-4 captures, I guess. But this is a beautiful little fish. Nice little hump there. Good proportion. Hard fighting, likes the ghost. Well pleased. Like I say, it's got to be 10-12 pound probably. But I'm not going to weigh it. I'm just going to take it down river and slip it back and get the bait out again. I think I might stay a little bit longer tonight. So good, we've had a fish. This is one of the culprits that's been taken to bait. And possibly one of the fish that I saw in the group of 9, possibly. Or a nomad, or one I've just not spotted. Right, let's slip it back downriver. Actually, I think I'll slip it back upriver. Floating weed coming in now in front of our lines. We've already got some behind the lines, so it's getting a bit closed up. It's only a small amount, so I'm not too concerned about it. If we get any more, I'm going to take the rods out again, but I don't need bags in this swim anymore. All the weed's been cleared away by the carp or whatever, clearing up all this bait, so. Well, that's a good sign, isn't it, catching that fish. I think that might have been one of the smaller fish that I saw with the main group. Difficult, always difficult to count, you know. I thought I counted 9 one day, so yeah. It's a pity they weren't all 20s and 30s and maybe even a 40, I don't know, but it won't surprise me if a can turns up a 40. It won't surprise me at all. It's already turned up 36 a couple of times, so you know. Well, it's just gone 8 o'clock, so that fish was quite late for me. Normally I've had a fish by about 7 o'clock, so I think it's a good idea. I think it's a good idea what I do is start coming later, staying later and having my dinner before I come down here. I think that's what I'll do. Because you know, the evening spell just before dark can be very, very good. And I am missing out on that. Still good, the bait's all going, I've caught a carp, we found a culprit. That's given me a lot of confidence and a bit of a boost, for sure. So it's well pleasing getting a fish, but it's definitely spurred me on to want to stay longer, I have to say. You never know what it's going to be when that bite alarm goes off. I mean, it could be a 30, it could
could be a 13 pounder. I've never seen any of the fish before. They've got no names as far as I know. There's a few lads carp fishing on the River Cam, you know, and there's been a few lads carp fishing it for a few years. A lot of it's kept pretty quiet as well, I think. Well, you can't blame them really, can you? But, you know, you can see from all the effort that I've put in, I've been coming down every day now for, well, it's first week of July, so four and a half weeks. Pretty much every day, yeah. And I've been putting half a key to a kilo in every day as well. I think I might have to cut back on the bait a little bit because it's costing a fortune. Even though I do get it a little bit cheaper, of course, but it's still costing. I do pay for my bait, actually. People think that I get it for free, but I don't. Well, it's time to go. Light's fading, and minutes are ticking away on the hard drive on this camera. I'm pleased with the result, though. One fish, you know, that's all you can expect, really, for a few hours of an evening. But I'll be back Friday night. I'll probably get here about sort of half six after dinner, and then fish right up until dark. But at the moment, I want to get home and cook my dinner. I'm starving. It's getting on for 9 o'clock now, so time to go.